Hey guys, I went bowling recently. I find it kind of weird that Canadians have smaller balls than the Americans do. I found that funny because we also have smaller bowling balls than the Americans. Remember online school? That was kind of a pain, wasn't it? The worst part is that you had to keep your camera on for the whole class. There's always that one kid changing his background every 2 seconds. Ocean, space, ocean, China, beach. But for some reason, they don't have a classroom one. I thought about changing my background to a picture of my face listening. Then I thought it would look way too fake if I didn't blink. So I had another background with my eyes closed, and every few seconds I would flip in between them, making it look like I'm blinking. The teacher quickly realized that it was fake and it looked way too creepy, as I would just stare into the camera for 2 hours, not moving a single muscle for the whole class. Just joking, I didn't do it yet. Online school reminds me of Fortnite, not because I played it during it, but because there's three types of people. There's the two people that always answer the questions and carry the whole class. There's the guy that always interrupts the other guy before he says the answer, stealing kills. Then there's a camper just like me, who just wait for the class to finish. Can't get me if you can't see me. All I need now is a bush profile picture. Then there's the kids that joined the wrong meet or slash server and never show up on time. Ever have airplane food? If you never had airplane food, just imagine the kind of food you'd find in a plastic bag abandoned on the floor of a public bathroom. Ever had one of their soups though? Don't know why they even call that a soup. It's just slightly tinted orange water with a piece of someone's leftover chicken floating at the bottom. It's so weird how we leave behind food in public bathrooms. Just the other day, I saw a half-eaten cucumber slice. Who the heck does it finish one cucumber slice then throws it in the toilet? So disgusting. Recently realized that they have a measure printed on the side of barf bags, like down to the millimeter even. Who the heck would be measuring how much they've thrown up? Like a doctor will be asking how many inches you barfed. Don't you find it a little weird that they have to specify unarmed in all the animation titles and core, like unarmed wave or unarmed sleep? Makes me wonder if there is an armed sleep. One time I was in second grade and we had some spare time, so the teacher brings us over to the computer room. All the computers haven't been replaced since the school was built for some reason, and I could tell because I had over 60 notifications telling me to update to Windows Vista. Don't even know what that is. Our teacher told us never click on something while it's loading or else the computer will shut down, and they would have to get the technician over to deal with this. So we have some free time and she says, feel free to play whatever game you like. All bad games are blocked. And do not watch videos on YouTube. It can be on other sites, but not YouTube. Now, if you know anything about the internet, you know encouraging kids to go on other sites to watch videos isn't a great idea. And if you get a virus, I don't think those dinosaur computers have the hardware to defend themselves, to be honest. I don't think they even have the hardware to be a computer. It's weird how schools ban every game with guns. Like they think a 2D pixelated gun composed of two rectangles in a game could make us become a school shooter. Yet they make us do dance class throughout 7 years. When we were younger in winter, we liked to build snow forts as most kids did. As we wanted to have the best snow fort in the schoolyard, we would form groups, and we needed someone to make the decisions about the fort. We would designate the fort leader, that would be called the chef, which means the chief. The rest of us just became workers, or demi-chefs, which means half-chiefs, or assistant chiefs. All recess, we would be intensely making these huge snowballs to build the walls of our fort. As the snow got thin from overuse, we started to look for different resources that we could later trade for more land or more people to grow the fort. Now, the kids came up with an idea, colored snowballs, which was really just different colors of markers scribbled on a snowball. Now, this quickly became the main source of trading in the yard. With great riches, there's always going to be thieves. Forts were starting to hire spies to go and steal the precious colored snowballs. Wars would even start to occur in between the forts. Like, they would send out a group of people to go fight the other fort and loot it. Got so crazy, the teacher had to ban all colored snowballs in the yard. They said no one owns the snow. I don't know if the teacher ever took history before, but communism never works out. There were some kids that would grab these vines off the back. Sorry about that. Yeah, so some kids would grab these vines off the back fence, and they would just whip the heck out of anyone who would step close to their fort. And remember, we were just in grade 5. It turns out it wasn't just our school. This was happening all across Canada. Well, besides the vine thing. It even inspired a movie to be created called La Guerre des Tuques, which means The War of the Tuques. Great movie, by the way. I would strongly recommend it. Thanks for enjoying this cringe. Have a good night.
Next up, we have stand-up comedy by Acrix. Please welcome Acrix.
What's up, everybody? Y'all know me probably from last show. But I'm not going to take too long. So, yeah. Thank you for your time. What do you lives together? Broommates. Where does the sheep go to get a haircut? The bot shop. Some people eat snails. They must not like fast food. Why did the frog take the bus today? His car got towed away. What do you call a can opener that doesn't work? A can't opener. Thank you for having me, and yeah, thank you for enjoying all this pain together. Peace out.
You know the bed feels warmer sleeping here alone. You know I dream in color and do the things I want. You think you got the best of me, think you've had the last laugh, but you think that everything good is gone. Think that I'll come running back. Maybe you don't know me cause you're dead wrong. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Stand a little taller. Doesn't mean I'm lonely when I'm alone. What doesn't kill you makes you brighter. What's that fever lighter? Doesn't mean I'm lonely cause you're gone. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Stand a little taller. Doesn't mean I'm lonely when I'm alone. You heard that I was starting over with someone new. They told you I was moving on over you.
failure makes you stronger. Stand a little taller. Doesn't mean I'm lonely when I'm alone. What doesn't kill you makes a fighter. Footsteps even lighter. Doesn't mean I'm over, cause you're gone. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger.
Oh, the okay, you can start. Please welcome Tetasaur with his pirate jokes.
Haha, hope you're all doing nice. Me and my twin here will be doing pirate jokes. So, why don't pirates shower before they walk the plank? Because they'll just wash up on the shore later. Why is pirating so addictive? They say once you lose your first hand, you get hooked. How do pirates know they're pirates? They think, therefore they are. How did the pirate get his Jolly Roger so cheaply? He bought it on sale. What has eight legs, eight hands, and eight eyes? Eight pirates, they all be missing an arm, a hand, and an eye. What do you call a pirate with two eyes and two legs? A rookie. What did the ocean say to the pirate? Nothing, it just waved. Why does it take a pirate so long to learn the alphabet? Because they can spend years at sea. How much did the pirate pay for his piercings? A buccaneer. How much did the pirate pay for his peg leg and hook? An arm and a leg. Where can you find a pirate who lost both his wooden legs? Right where you left him. How do pirates prefer to communicate? Eye to eye. And finally, what are the 10 letters of the pirate alphabet? I, R, and the 7 C's. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Ha ha.
Tequila.
Thank you. I sit beside the fabulous mango boy? Beside the...
Sit on the couch. Sit on the couch.
How about I sit right here? No. How come? Wait, you bet because... I can get up on this? Wait, if I can, like, sit up on here...
Okay, so... Bronzeword is a speedrunner slash parkour professional on Core and Roblox. He's been on Core for, I think, now 2 years.
Indeed.
And...
And?
Okay, so, Bronze, what is your favorite game?
My favorite game? Well, I know there's a lot of people listening in the audience right now, so I feel like it would be cruel of me to not say Clicking Simulator or Coffee Shop. So I'm going to go with those two right now. And Arcade Planet, of course.
Okay, so Bronze, what is your favorite game on Roblox?
My favorite game on Roblox? My favorite game on Roblox is Adopt Me, because I find it...
Yeah, that's what I thought. What is your favorite game that's not on Core?
But Mango, I thought you knew these questions already, because you were me the last time I saw you in Oddcore Out.
Yeah.
You should know all these answers already.
Just answer the question.
Okay, sorry.
What's your favorite game that's off Core?
Is that a microwave I hear in the background? Are you, like, cooking Pop-Tarts? Favorite game that's not on Core? Sorry, you have to repeat the question. I wasn't paying attention. I saw a me standing crawling behind you. Seems you even forgot the question you were going to ask.
Pretend it's not there. Pretend it's not there.
All right.
What's your favorite game that's not on Core?
Oh man, my favorite game that's not on Core. Fart Night.
Okay. Okay. What is your best game you've ever made?
The best game I've ever made? Here, I'll demonstrate it for you real quick.
Oh, yeah. Corpse Disrespect for RP, I remember that.
Oh, yeah.
It's pretty fun. Pretty, pretty carpal tunnel, you know?
Yeah. This is the new Disrespect. Yo, but that game actually be popping, though. It's got 1,000 visits. Like, let's go.
What's your favorite Core asset?
Favorite Core asset? Gold pile, because people mistaken it for a grass hill.
Are you sure it's not generic Beam Hero 1?
What?
There's a new asset called Generic Beam 01.
I did not know that.
It's like one of the first assets now.
That's very interesting. Thank you for enlightening me.
Coral table. My favorite one is definitely a basic cube 01. You can make so much stuff with it.
I agree.
Okay, next interview. Petasaur, do you want to be interviewed?
Sure.
Okay.
Let me just find a place to rest my bones real quick.
Perfect. Oh, Tensor, you haven't done your pirate jokes yet.
Oh, that's true. Well, there's always time for pirate jokes. Everyone's got time for pirate jokes.
We'll do that after. We'll do that after the interview. Okay, so Tensor, when did you get into the game dev business?
Been working on games and helping people make games since about 2013.
Wow, long time ago.
I was just a wee baby Tetathor back then.
Yeah. What's your favorite game?
In core?
No, of anywhere.
Of anywhere? Favorite game? For me, it's going to be the Fable series. Fable 1, I think, was my first introduction to an RPG game, and I was hooked ever since. I think I was 10 when that game came out, and I don't think I left my house, talked to my parents or any of my friends for a solid 2-3 weeks.
Okay. I'm actually too young to have heard of that game. Tell us about it.
It is a action RPG that came out on the original Xbox, made by a British studio called Lionhead. And so because it was this British studio, it had this sense of a British charm and humor about it. So it was all about morality. You could be good or evil. You could be rich or poor. You could do horrible things like kick chickens around and marry an evil necromancer, or you can be really good and donate all your money to charity. At that time, though, I was a 10-year-old and an edgelord, and so I wanted to be as evil as possible. So if there was an evil path to take, I took it every single time. I'm reformed now, though. I'm all about the straight and narrow.
Okay. What was your favorite game jam on core?
Favorite game jam? Ooh, that is a good question. I would have to say probably the Deadmau5 jam was my favorite.
Oh yeah, that one was really good. The live event was like super cool.
That was the first time that live event was the first time I had audibly gasped from because of a game since maybe the first time I played Skyrim.
Wow. What's your favorite game on core?
Oh man, that is a tricky question because it always changes. Usually it's whichever boot camp game that I'm playing at that moment, which for anyone who has been in boot camp, there's a lot of boot camp games to play. But my heart is always going to stay true to Coffee Shop by Disaster.
Yeah, it's very, very unique. I found a Squidward on the chair on the Easter egg on the roof.
I have yet to get to the roof. I would love to one day get on the roof and have my name amongst the other champions.
Yeah, I can show you how.
Please do. I need a little extra help.
And what was your experience on Scratch?
Oh man, I was referred to as the Scratch Master, actually. Some of my best games have ever come out on Scratch. I made 2D platformers. One was called Space Quest, which had robot crabs that would explode. My personal favorite one, though, was called Protect the Tikka Masala. And you had a paintball gun, and you had to shoot approaching Tetathors who were getting closer to a bowl of Tikka Masala and a side of garlic naan. And if any of the Tetathors touched the Tikka Masala, it was game over. So it was quite difficult because there's a lot of them. I think at one point there's like 300 Tetathors on screen.
Yeah. On Scratch, I've actually made quite a few games. I've been doing Scratch since I was like a 10 or something, but yeah, I just go on Scratch every now and then and like make an animation or something.
Scratch, I would say, is my favorite platform to make things on besides Core. And until I had access to Photoshop and other photo editing tools, Scratch was actually my preferred photo editing platform as well, because it's just super easy to, you know, just edit something or get rid of a background. So yeah, people don't sleep on Scratch. It's great for photo editing if you don't want to pay any money for Photoshop.
Yeah, I use it too for like just like making little art things. If I ever need like an item for like a thumbnail of a game or a video.
There's also a Photopea, which is completely free, and it's basically just Photoshop.
Yeah. So, how about we interview Carmel?
Okay.
Tedithor, you can come on the interviewing chair now.
Oh, perfect. I've been waiting for this moment.
Okay, so Carmel, where do you get the username Carmel from?
I had a pet that was a caramel color, and it was gonna be Caramel Games, but I forgot an A, so now just Carmel Games.
Yeah.
Carmel Games, would you agree that you are the smelliest Corian out of all the core players there are?
No comment.
Fair enough.
Carmel Games, what is your favorite core asset, and why is it Carl?
It's actually, we call it Ben Ben. It's kind of like an inside joke from Core Live. It's that orange ball. That orange and white ball.
Yeah.
I think it's called Ball 1.
When I was new to Core, I used that just as a sphere. I didn't use like the basic sphere 01. I used the Ben Ben.
Yeah. Why was it called Ben Ben again?
I don't know.
Wait, let's ask Puff.
Yeah, player one. Yeah, what's it? What was the name of the bean thing?
Oh, that was, 1UP.
Oh, 1UP, yeah. 1UP, the beans are gone. Walmart finds the beans are gone. How did he come up with that, honestly? Like, if it was like a Walmart game series, you know, the fifth one in the series, then in this one, the catastrophe is that all the beans are gone. Yeah, everyone can go on stage after the show.
There's phantom candy being thrown through the walls. This special place is effect. Haunted.
Yeah.
Carmel, if you could be any type of candy, what kind of candy would you be?
Kit Kat.
Solid choice.
You had a cat named Kit Kat.
You wouldn't see. It's not caramel, but
I think there's a caramel flavored Kit Kat.
You know, in Japan, they have like 1,000 different flavors of Kit Kat. Yeah, they have 1,000 flavors of everything.
Carmel, I have a very specific question for you. Are you ready for this?
Yeah.
Which user supported you the most and gave you the most feedback in your first game, Narf?
My first Narf? Like Narf 1?
Yes.
I would say Puff, but he joined a little bit after.
We found him. We found him in a survival template. Survival starter kit. Yeah, Indeed. The bunny skin didn't even come out yet. That was at the City Jam.
I think it was King Zulu.
Oh yeah. Who's the person who's tipped the most core credits?
Puffball, for sure.
Me, I'd say probably Puff and Trashbird.
Puffed up like 2,000 maybe? Like in total?
By the way, there's a tip jar at the entrance if anyone wants a tip.
It doesn't let me tip. I got 2 core credits and then I try and it says
it's 50 core credits.
I can't give you my 2 core credits.
I don't want your 2 core credits. Does anyone else want to be interviewed?
Let's get a Grayson.
I'm pretty sure I just banned him.
I thought you're not allowed to ban players on core.
No, I banned them from the game. Like, I have admin commands.
He kicked them.
No, I banned him. Dude.
Everyone here knows, right, that it was Blue Clary's birthday 6 days ago. Can we all sing happy birthday?
Yeah, let's do that.
Okay. 1, 2, 3. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Hello? I think I hit my mic.
What is your mic?
I guess it says connecting on the
connecting on the voice chat channel.
Connecting, then you need to have the
recorder.
The real storm over here.
Chopper, do you want to be interviewed? Chopperin, do you want to be interviewed? That wasn't an option. It's yes, or my bodyguard, I mean the security guard.
Oh god.
Will snipe you.
Mango Boy, would you like to be interviewed?
Yes, I would like to be interviewed.
Alright. So, Mango Boy, please, first introduce yourself to the audience here.
Hello, I am Mango Boy, and I'm a mango and stuff. I make games and stuff.
Please tell us the origin of your username, Mango Boy.
Well, I was gonna download Core, and it was like taking forever. Then when I was finally done downloading, I'm like, I want my username to be good. But I don't want to waste time thinking about it. And a good thing to do is have your username as an object or something that you can have like a character that like represents you as. Like everyone knows me by my cartoon Mango Guy. So I'm like, huh, Mango Boy.
So I hear that when Carmel was signing up to Core, he mistyped caramel and wrote Carmel.
Yes, that is in fact true.
What would happen if you mistyped your name and you were actually Manga Boy? How would you feel about that?
Fun fact, I don't like manga. It's like so confusing because you read it from left to right and it's like so confused, like you open the book. And then at the first page, it's just like the grand, like the big twist at the end, you know? So, yeah.
Yeah.
Mango Bo.
Can you please tell me the last time you died in Core Royale?
It's been a while, because Core Royale has like money now. but it's like not set up yet. So if you die, you lose all your money. So if you're gonna get killed, you just have to leave the game. Or if you even won, you have to leave the game because it's gonna teleport you back to the lobby, and then you'll lose all your money. So it's, I'm not sure.
That is the wrong answer. You are a Mango Boy, the god of all guns. You have never died in Core Royale. Womp womp Okay, last question for you, Mango Boy.
Why there's a twin of you with a white Nerf gun and an oversized headset and sunglasses?
I got one last question for you, Mango Boy. Are you ready for this? Okay?
Yeah.
If you could collaborate in a game jam with any two people in the audience right now, which two people would you collaborate?
Random Phantom, for sure. Because, you know, he has the most popular game on Core, and he's very good at making games. And, maybe...
Right answers only. There's a lot at stake right now.
Okay, and,
And that's all we got for folks. Yeah, thank you. Okay, let's see, Shallow, are you ready to do your performance now?
So, Acrix, is it pronounced Quebec or Quebec?
Quebec.
Exactly, Quebec. Ça, c'est comme, tout le monde, il dit comme Quebec, mais c'est vraiment juste Quebec.
Yep, exactly. You get it
there's
right.
There's no O. There's no O.
Exactly.
What's your favorite game?
My favorite game? I don't really have any favorite game, but I just like kind of switch. I stay for a long period sometimes on a game, and then I go to another and do the same thing. But right now, I'm on Black Ops 2. I play a lot of Call of Duty Black Ops 2, Zombie, and multiplayer. Yeah, I just wanted to have a nostalgic trip, but mostly I mostly like it too, like just for fun. But before Black Ops 2, it was Core for sure.
Okay, yeah, if anyone's being sus in the chat, just feel free to kick them. Yeah. Okay, what's your favorite kind of I don't know, plant, flower?
I'd say lavender.
Yeah. Me would be hibiscus. Because I
have a
name.
I have a question. Did you ever go to a cabana sick?
All the time. All the time.
In March. In March it's always the best.
Exactly. We're going actually in March. Are y'all going?
I hope so. I mean, yeah. Hopefully.
Yeah, because of COVID.
Yeah, there's like, when you go to like a local cabana six, the tea, you know the tea?
Mm-hmm.
It's so good.
I know. It's just like, melts in the mouth. It's so good.
Yeah.
No hearts broken today.
A trash bird.
Okay, so you made your point. I'm a trash man who only knows trash birds.